Hello and welcome back. By reading your comments, I can see that we agree on many things, especially concerning modern vinyl reissues. Most of them sound like crap, and we all seem to agree on that. But the thing is that a lot of you were into vinyl and moved or switched to digital or downloads because it's very difficult to find original pressings in very good conditions, and you're gonna fork out a lot of money for them. And most of the times, let's be honest, what you get is a very good plus if you're lucky, or an excellent. And even though I don't think it's really worth the expense. So in this video, I want to show you some reissues, but vintage reissues, mainly from the 70s and 80s, that sound phenomenal. Maybe not as good as first pressings, right? But they still sound great, and they still make me believe on vinyl, and they certainly sound much better than any CD or digital incarnations I have of these albums. Right, so let's get on with it. And if you're new to the channel, please consider subscribing and become a member of my family. We're going to start with RCA, the American record company. RCA, it's a record giant and has always been. And in the 1970s and 80s, he had lots of branches in the UK and in Europe, many factories and many pressing plants. In the early 80s, like 1980, 81, the international branch of RCA decided to put out a whole collection of vinyl records covering most of their well-known artists. Most of the reissues I have from the time sound great, and the best thing about them is that you can find them in near mint condition, and sometimes even mint, for not much money, and it's a guarantee of having a very good sounding vinyl record. They're very easy to spot, right? We start with a classic, right? David Bowie, Ziggy Stardust, right? What a great album, right? You see, this one is near mint, is almost mint on the cover and both the record. All these international releases, they all have in common the label, right? You got to look for to keep an eye out on green or black labels, right? And they have the RCA logo on the right, as you can see, and then there's something written on linea tres, which means line three, here on the right, 3 o'clock position. And as I said, sometimes they're black and sometimes they're green. The UK branch and some European ones used RCA International. Many artists that you can find. I'm sure they will suit most of them will suit your tastes, and they're great as plain copies. As I said, maybe not the best sounding copies they are, but they're still very good. This is an example. I'll show you just two or three, right? I got a whole lot of them. They usually come as well with the Best Buy series information on the back cover. I don't know about this one, but this one for instance does. You see here, right? Best Buy series. This is a Transformer, Lou Reed Transformer, also from their RCA collection. And as you can see, right, this one is on the black label, All right. RCA logo on the left. And they all come from the same collection, right? So it's a very inexpensive and a very fast way to get hold of many, many interesting vinyl that, to me, just my personal opinion, sound better than CDs or digital incarnations. And I would certainly go for some of these before splurging for new modern vinyl reissues, right? Which I, most of them, I mean, they're disgraceful. We're turning back down now, and the year is 1978. For some reason, I've been doing some research, but there's not much information on Discogs or anywhere else, for that matter, on the internet. It was a great year, 1978, for Dutch presence. There must have been, but I don't know, right? But there must have been great engineers at the helm during those years in the Netherlands. And they reissued not only you know, the local copies just from their own market, but they also put out records for the whole European and British market, right? And they're very interesting. The good thing about 1978 is that these copies used to fly under the radar, and not many people are aware of them. And the good thing, they're not really inexpensive, but the good thing about them is that if you buy from a reliable seller, you're bound to get near mint or even mint copies. I'll give you two great, great examples, right? First one is Dark Side of the Moon, right? This is the Dutch pressing from 1978. As you can see, the cover, right, it's in absolutely mint condition. Here's the serial number, 1A0620524. I hope the camera can get that. And this one, it's in near mint condition. It doesn't have the inserts, but as I have so many copies of Dark Side of the Moon, I don't really need some more inserts, right? Here it is, right? The sound is jaw-dropping. It's absolutely fantastic. I don't miss having any other copy of Dark Side of the Moon, well, other than the UK first pressing. But this one is really good enough. Mine has a few ticks at the beginning of side one, right? Before Speak to Me, but just three or four of them. The rest of side one is absolutely clean. And side two is just perfect, right? From Money till the End, I can hardly hear any imperfections. Was it expensive? Well, by today's standards, I don't really think so. I bought it without the inserts, and I paid something like 35 for it, right? There is a white vinyl pressing, right, done with the same stamper, but that one is gonna, you know, it's gonna set you about a lot of money, maybe because of, you know, of the gimmick of the white vinyl thing. But if you're not interested in these herds, or you can live without them, and you just want a very, very good sounding copy, to me, much better than any modern reissues, and that goes for the 30th anniversary as well, I would just try to find one of these Dutch pressings. And if Pink Floyd was not enough, what about the Beatles? The Stereo White Album. This one is from 1978 as well. I don't know the master's engineers. I don't know who was in charge of the Dutch branch of EMI at the time. All I can tell you is this sounds so smooth, right? It's so compelling. It's just such a great listening experience. And I mean, I've got some other stereos. I've got the German one, I've got a UK pressing, but my go-to copy when I want to listen to the stereo album, right? I prefer the mono, but if I want to play the stereo album, I play this Dutch copy, close my eyes, and enjoy, right? But remember, the year is 1978. Now, we're going to talk of an album that we all know, and maybe we're just fed up with it, and it's understandable because of all these acoustic sounds, reissues, and the 75th anniversary, and it's going over the same war horses over and over again. But I had to let on what I feel about this copy because some of you will be interested. Talking about Steely Dan Gaucho, right? This is the Japanese first pressing, 1980. Now I have, I suppose, like you do, I don't know, five, six, seven copies of Gaucho. Some of you probably have bought the UHGR reissue and you're perfectly happy with it, or you got the US Ludwig, the original pressing, and it's fine by you. And I understand that. And I never even thought about buying this Japanese pressing, but it was watching a YouTube channel that made me think about it, right? Because the guy raved so much and about this Japanese pressing, and it was not a random guy. It was somebody who knew, you know, what he was he knew what he was talking about. And I said, well, let's give it a chance if I find an inexpensive copy. And I did. I got this one for about 35. But I suppose you can get even cheaper copies if you don't mind the obi and the lyrics. If it's not for collection purposes, if it's just for as a plain copy. Why do I like this one so much? Because it to me it sounds as good as the Bob Ludwig, the American first pressing. But the highs here are tamed, but in a good way. That means I always found Ludwig mastering brilliant. I mean, he even got a Grammy Award for it, and really, really good sounded. But whenever I played Gaucho, I've always thought of, you know, those highs, you know, they could be tamed a little bit, right? People tell me they are on the UHQR. I haven't got it. But when I play this one, it was just exactly what I was hoping for. Great sound stage, great instrument separation, fantastic low end, and to me the highs on this copy are just exactly the way I like them, right? The way I want this album to sound, right? So give it a second thought, right? And follow my advice. You won't regret it. The Kinks. If you're a Kinks fan as well, the Kinks are on my top three lists of 60s bands, together with the Beatles and the Who. To me, Raymond Davis is one of the greatest songwriters ever. But Kinks' mono albums from the 60s are hard to come by. And they're usually very expensive, let alone items like something else. One of my favorite is this one, Village Green Preservation Society. In Germany in the 1980s, they re-released the 1960s Kinks albums in mono, right? Unfortunately, not all of them. They didn't do something else, but they did this one, and it sounds great, great. Here's the label, right? The Pi Records label, and I hope you can read mono there, and it sounds as good as I've got a 60s copy, and it sounds almost just as good, and for a fraction of the price. These ones are inexpensive, right? So be on the lookout for Kinks re-releases in Germany in the early 80s, right? And you're going to find them in very good condition, even near mint copies or even minty copies, and you'd be very happy to collect some of these. Let's go back to the States. Santana, Abraxas. I know this is well, a holy grail for many Santana's fans. I know Abraxas is an album many people love, and they want to have the perfect copy of, right? They buy the UHQR, they buy the one step, they buy any copy on earth, right? I like the album, I love it, but I'm not such a great fan, right? And a good sounding copy is good enough for me. So I got this one some time ago for very little money. It's again a Dutch pressing for the European market. They are plentiful, right? If you go to if you search Discogs, there are many, many releases of these Dutch pressings, right, for the European market, and sold very well. Most of them, you can find them in great condition, in near mint condition. And I love the way this sounds, right? I love the way it sounds. I suppose I can't compare to a new HQR or to the one step, but I'm talking about, €20 here, £20, right? Compared to 125 or 150. And you can even buy two copies of the albums, right? And enjoy yourself. The sound is phenomenal. There's great separation. The guitar sounds fantastic. The congas, bongos, and the Hammond organ, everything is in place. As you know, for about four decades, side one has the stereo channel reversed on side one, and this is no exception, right? That wasn't corrected till 2008, if I'm not mistaken. But I mean, if you're not happy with that, you can always switch the jack connectors, right? And no big deal, I suppose. Right, and the last one, I'm going to talk about the band, not an album, right? I'm going to show you an album, this one, even in the quietest moment, Supertramp. But I want to go through the whole collection. It's difficult when you want to buy a Supertramp album. It's got many quiet sections, and it's very difficult to find items without clicks and pops, and items you're not very happy with. I'll tell you a way to find very good sounding Supertramp albums in very good conditions. They all have a trumpet logo on the run out grooves. Now, I did my homework, I looked it up, and apparently that's the A&M logo, right? It resembles a very small trumpet. And it was used both in the States and in the Netherlands as well, and Germany. The European ones were done at Haarlem, the Netherlands, right? And they were used for the whole European market. Except the first two albums, right, which do not have the trumpet logo, you can get the rest of the collection very easily. You can buy them for very little money, and they're very, very good sounding pressing. Maybe not the best there is, but I'm sure you're going to be really happy, right? Certainly sound much better than any CDs or digital incarnations, right? So keep an eye out for the whole collection. It's very easy to find them because other than the trumpet logo, they got these inner sleeves, right? From A&M, right? With more albums, right? From the same time, right? from the same selling time, I mean. Right, and that's basically it. That's all I had to say today. I hope you liked it. Thanks for your time. Thanks for listening. Take care.